Please feel free to use them. We're going to get going here. Kimber, come have a seat. Yeah. Andy. Why don't you and Kimber sit down? Well, thank you, everybody, for being here. It's really fun to see this project finish. I want to thank a lot of people. You know, anytime you start thanking people, you're going to leave somebody out. But here goes anyway. Trustee Barbara Humphreys came today, and I'm so glad that she did with her husband Bobby, which is wonderful. Our board has been incredibly supportive of things like this, trusting that we'll do it, and we'll do it the right way and do it responsibly. And so thank you for that. A number of folks from Dr. Watt's cabinet are here. He's easy to spot. Jim Bakken. Is easy to spot. He's in the back there. I saw Dr. Chris Brown here. I saw Tom Brannon somewhere. There's Tom right up front. Thank you, Tom. Saw Brian Burnett. And let's see, Janet May I know was coming. And I see John Jones. Thank you, John, for being here. Oh, there's Janet. Thank you. Thanks, everybody, for being here and being a part of it. I see Sewell McKee. Sewell's here from McKee and Associates. That's the architect. You can thank Sewell for his hard work, him and his team. And I saw some folks from Stone Construction who did the work here as well. You know, a number of people from our facilities team. Boo Brown, who's our interior decorator, designer. Sorry, she hates that word. Our interior designer, Boo Brown, and Billy Higginbotham, who spent just hours and hours on this project. So thanks to all those folks, and also thanks to Borden Lassier and Lizzie Dumas and Brendan Dwyer from our facilities team and Matt Wilt, who have worked really hard to try to get this place mopped and cleaned and set up so that we could have this. Thank you, Andy Kennedy. Absolutely. So this, I want to talk about what this used to be. So this was two gyms. Just like this in terms of space on the floor, but there was this old balcony track. It was about 15 feet wide that ran around the perimeter. And I saw Drew Ferguson. Where is Drew? He's right here. Drew Ferguson talked about how he used to run around that track years and years ago. There was no air conditioning in this building. So you think about the Alabama heat and what that presented. And the roof leaked a lot. It was a really old roof. You know, this place is about 50 years old. And the lighting was dim, and we had six racquetball courts, which are behind us, and that's what we've been able to convert here. But these six racquetball courts, and this was the original rec center. You know, this was a really great facility at one time. We still have the swimming pool on the other side of that wall over there, if you're interested in taking some laps. So we left that, but what we had come to after building the new rec center over on University Boulevard is our rifle team would use one of these racquetball courts down on the end. That's where that was their practice facility. And what's really funny about that is that the distance that they were practicing on was shorter than the distance they used to compete. And so it's like basketball shooting on a 9-foot rim. And that's what they did every day. And then out here in the court space, there was about 6 hours of activity every week used by the PE department, and so they've been able to relocate their classes over to the rec center, which is really, if you haven't been there, is another beautiful space here on campus. But it's important when you're in an urban environment to be able to use your space to the best of your ability, and not, you know, your land is precious on every campus, but particularly one like ours. And so I'm really pleased that we were able to reuse this space and really bring new life and rejuvenate this space with new and restored energy. There's also a great, when you walked in the plaza and the entrance back here in the corner, you're immediately next to, we're now immediately next to our training room. So it's right here on the other side of the wall. And then there's a weight room, the old Bell Gym, where old Steve Mitchell used to practice. The old Bell Gym is right there on the other side. It's now a weight room, and it is fantastic. So just the proximity for our teams and what that represents is also really great. So you know, what is it now? You can see we've replaced the floor. We replaced the roof. And when we showed our men's and women's teams here a few days ago, we showed them through, and a couple of players like, wait, no more trash cans? We don't have the trash cans sitting around anymore? And no, we fortunately have gotten rid of the trash cans, and we don't have the leaky roof anymore. We redid that plaza that you entered through. I was really pleased with that. I may be the only person that was excited about that, but I was really excited about that. Just really opened that up, and there were these old brick archways that were only 7 feet tall, and so good old Trey Jemison from our team had to duck every time. Look, I'm not tall, but even I was ducking to try to just, anyway, so we were able to get rid of all that and really change the face of both sides of this building for the better. So, like I said, new floor, new goals all the way around. We got rid of that old balcony track. We added air conditioning, new lighting, and then we were able to take these racquetball courts because of the height of the ceiling, and we were able to put a second floor in. And so what you've got downstairs are player areas. You've got, you know, team lounge, locker room, video space, and upstairs are all the coaches' offices on both sides for men's and women's basketball. And then we found a few little Easter eggs here where we found some closets that we were able to add that we didn't know were here. And there was an old stairwell that went to that balcony track that obviously we didn't need anymore. So we were able to expand the size of our doctor's office on the other side, and we were able to add a laundry. So that, you know, is that a big deal? Well, yeah, if you're in the training room and you've been pulling a laundry cart for 45 years across the street to Bartow to do your laundry every day. So there's a lot of little things like that. I see trainers cheering. I know it's a small victory, but big for them, I'm telling you. You know, things like that we're able to do that really have made this more efficient for people just beyond basketball. And so this is a place where we're going to be able to, you know, our great coaches are going to be able to recruit more great players, and those great players can do what they do to be the very best versions of themselves right here in this facility. And it's going to open up a lot of scheduling conflicts that we had across the street in Bartow. If you can imagine three teams, men's basketball, women's basketball, and volleyball, all practicing and playing forever and ever right there on that one court. So being able to have this is tremendous for them. And so it's a wonderful day for our department, and a wonderful day for not just those teams, but really everybody here at UAB. And we've been able to build or renovate 25 new facilities just for athletics in the last 7 years. And that's a great tribute to all the other work that you see on our campus. If you see all these other, the cranes that are always seem to be popping up, and that's because of the vision of our president. And he's a UAB grad, and he's a Birmingham native, and it really matters to him. And so if you would, please help me thank and welcome our president, Dr. Ray Watts.
Well, thank you, Mark. It's a very exciting day for me. I've been looking forward to this facility being completed, and I think it gives you a glimpse into the future greatness of UAB basketball. This is a tremendous facility for our student athletes, for our coaches, for our teams, and I think that having the practice facility here with all the offices and amenities and locker rooms and weight rooms is just fabulous. As Mark said, it frees up Bartow for other activities, for other sports, and I think it just gives you a glimpse into the future of UAB athletics. As Mark said, how many facilities? 25? 25 facilities renovated over the last 7 years. And so we're not stopping here, but we're very pleased to be here today. We're grateful to our partners, Medical Properties Trust, represented today by Emmett O'Neill, a member of our UAB Athletics Foundation, our Blazer Boosters and alumni for their support, and our Athletics Foundation Basketball Facility Committee for their fundraising efforts. And to all of you who participated in very different ways, we're thankful. The UAB facilities team did a great job again. All we need to do is put things in their hands, and they always do a first-rate job, and we couldn't do it without them. Continue to unfold our master plan, as Mark said. We've built about 25 buildings in the last, built or renovated 25 buildings in the last 5 years, and we're going to do that plus over the next five. We invested $1 billion in the last 5 or 6 years. We're going to invest $1 billion in the next 5 or 6 years across the university and the health system. We're grateful to our Board of Trustees, represented today by Trustee Humphrey, for their unwavering support of all of the projects that we bring to them. Of course, we try not to bring to them anything that's not well planned, and I don't want anything brought to me that's not well planned. So when we work together, there's no limit to what we can do. Most recently, our men's squad earned their sixth conference title and made their 16th appearance in the NCAA tournament. Both our men's team and our women's team continue to excel under the leadership of Coach Kennedy and Coach Norton, and we have great aspirations and great hopes going forward. We're very excited to join the American Athletics Conference sometime over the next 1 to 2 years. We're working through that now. There are a lot of moving parts, but we're very excited about that. We think that'll help us be even more competitive, both in competition and in recruiting. I want to thank Mark for his leadership as our director of athletics. All of our athletics department staff, you do a great job every day, and we're proud of you and proud of what you do. So we're very glad to have you here with us today, and we look forward to cutting that ribbon and putting this beautiful facility online ASAP. Thank you, Mark.
Dr. Watts, thank you. We have a lot of really generous people here in Birmingham. We've been, as we said, building and renovating as fast as we can go, and we've just had incredible support from the community. Our Athletics Foundation has taken great pride in communicating and connecting us with a lot of people that we didn't know before, people who once we had a chance to sit down with them and talk about our vision and talk about why we're here and the value of UAB and how athletics plays a part and what our role is to promote the university, they get it. And they've been incredibly generous. So we're really fortunate to have somebody here from Medical Properties Trust to share their thoughts with us, because they made the lead gift that really ignited this campaign to make this happen. So if you would please help me welcome Mr. Emmett McLean. Thank you, Emmett.
Thanks, pal. This is the first time I've been in here since it's been finished, and it's just wow. I mean, what a great day for men's and women's basketball, and it's a great thing for UAB athletics, and for our company to be a part of it has been a very rewarding thing. I will say this, like any basketball is a team sport, this has been a team effort. There are so many people, there are too many to thank out here, individuals, corporations that made this happen, but we are super excited to be part of the university, the great leadership under Dr. Watts, the athletics, great leadership under you, Mark, and to be a part of this. It's the evolution of UAB, and it's great to see it continue to grow. So thank you very much.
Thank you. I said that this is a place where we're going to allow our great coaches to recruit more great talent like what we have and let that talent grow. He's already proven that he can win a championship and did a few years ago. Would you please welcome our women's basketball coach, Mr. Randy Norton.
What a great day to be a Blazer. And, you know, when I thought about that, it's especially fun to say as a basketball coach as you look around here. But I also want to say it's another great day to be a Blazer. So much momentum, so many things that Dr. Watts and Mark talked about, so much momentum, so many great things happening on campus here at UAB. Mark, Dr. Watts, we want to thank you for your vision and your foresight in making this happen. Thank you so much. Also, I want to thank our UAB development team for all your hard work, and of course, our ever loyal Blazer Booster members. Thank you so much. I've been with Mark 7 years. I've been here 9 years. That's hard for me to believe, but Mark came in about 7 years ago, and we're sitting down and we're talking about things. You know, his mind was just going. He's got all, and you can see how his mind works. But he's talking about, I got an idea. I think we can make Wallace into a practice facility. And I'm like, have you been over to Wallace to practice? You know, and what he was talking about, the garbage cans, I think men's and women's practiced the same day because it had been raining and Bartow was in use. And so we were over here practicing. And the truth is there were 5 garbage cans to catch the rain, and we were trying to run practice around it. So when Mark said, I think we can turn that into a practice facility, I just decided to trust you, Mark. So But yeah, this is a big deal for Andy and for women's basketball, for men's and women's basketball. Obviously, from a recruiting standpoint, quick example, Monday we had a big-time recruit here. She'd only been on campuses at Power 5 schools, and it was she and her dad. We walked them through the facility, and we got up to our offices up top, and he leans over to me, the dad, and says, you know, Coach, we've been on several Power 5 campuses, and this place is elite, and I couldn't agree with him more. So this is a great job by everybody. You know, for our men's and women's teams, you know, Bartow Arena is amazing. It's an amazing place to play, but it's in use a lot. And now we've got a place where men and women can get in. They can work on their craft 24/7. They'll have a key card. They can come in here and get shots anytime they want. And then the other thing that I think you're going to really enjoy, you've got the coaches' offices upstairs, but down below, they've done an incredible job creating an area for the players to congregate. And as we all know, to win championships, you've got to have team chemistry. You've got to be able to bond. Well, this is, it's kind of like a one-stop shop. You know, you've got your, the players can play. I'm not going to give everything away. I want you to walk through it and see it. But you've got the court. You've got an area where the players can hang out. And so we're just so excited. And if Michael Derringer wasn't here, I'd see if we could practice tonight. Michael, where's Michael? Is that all right? Probably not. We can't practice right now. But, again, we're honored. We're humbled. And we're so excited that to be able to practice in this state-of-art facility. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Randy, thank you. So we keep talking about these trash cans. But so 2 years ago, sitting with Coach Kennedy in his living room, and he was talking about his goals for our program, and he said, we're going to win a championship. And I said, great, I want to win one too. And he says, no, I'm talking about winning one year one. And sadly, he fell short. But he did manage to do it in year two, which is pretty darn good. But in year one, he's over here for practice, and he just takes a picture during practice of these trash cans and all this water everywhere. And he was just like, seriously? We got to get this done. And I came running over here. I thought, oh, gosh, what is it? And there were all these trash cans. And these guys were dodging around them like they were defenders, you know, going around these cans. And it's just, you know, you can laugh about it now because otherwise you'd have cried. But it is remarkable. And appreciate your trust, Randy, and appreciate Andy's trust as well. And so he has a great perspective, not just as our coach, but as a former player. And just fresh off of our most recent conference title and NCAA appearance, please welcome your head men's basketball coach, Andy Kennedy.
Thank you, Mark. I said it, I think, at the groundbreaking when we started this project in earnest. It's one thing to have a vision, but to see that vision come into fruition is something very special. So I appreciate you, Dr. Watts. I appreciate you, Mark, Emmett. Thank you. I remember sitting at the breakfast. Don't you remember? You were there. Broken Egg, I think. Shout out to Broken Egg. Wasn't that what it was? And we were talking about different things. And I remember vividly saying, okay, well, where are we short? I'll do it. Boom, just like that. The synergy, just like you said. The community has embraced UAB, just as UAB embraces the community. It's a very, very special place, and I'm so excited to be back a part of it. Steve Mitchell, I heard your name. Where are you, Steve? Yeah, I see you now. I see you. He and I could go back and forth about it. I cannot wait to bring former players, great players such as Steve, back into this building because when I was here, this was the Student Rec Center. And you would walk in that door, and you would play this way, racquetball courts here, weightlifting going on. It was quite a scene, but it was a who's who of basketball in this community in here playing on Saturdays. From the Steve Mitchells to the Charles Barkleys to the Enos Watleys, Buck Johnson's waiting for next game. literally, because all of the people in Birmingham would come back and be a part of this facility. So I'm really looking forward to having great basketball back in this facility again sooner rather than later. Isn't this magnificent? It's amazing what a couple of light bulbs and a bucket of paint will do, isn't it? It's really going to do wonders for both programs, both Randy's and mine, simply because it allows us to be efficient in our work. It allows us to work. It allows us to have an opportunity to not only showcase this, and it's already paid dividends. As Randy said, I've walked a number of recruits through here in the last couple of weeks, and thankfully they've all signed on the dotted line. So I think this building is batting 1,000 for us. I don't know about for you, but we're 4 for 4 in here so far. And they all come in and they're blown away with not only the efficiency of the space, but again, it reflects on the tradition of both programs, and it's something that we can all certainly be very proud of. So, again, thanks to all involved. I know there's so many people sitting here today that have made huge contributions, not only to this facility, but to UAB as a whole over the years. And our goal, again, is to build off of the momentum that has been created. I know my guys, many of them are here, are excited to get in here and christen this officially and call it home. Bartow Arena is special. Over there, you can watch a little basketball. You can get a COVID shot. I think you can get your tag renewed. There's a little volleyball over here. I mean, so this is going to do wonders in taking some stress off good old Bartow and also allowing us to be efficient in what we're trying to get accomplished. So thank you for being here. It's a special day for UAB Athletics, and it would not be possible without you. Thank you.
Andy's not wrong. We did do COVID shots at Bartow Arena. And for those of you who live locally, it's your new polling place. So we do use it for a lot of different things. Hey, put it to good use. So I mentioned that we showed our teams through here on Monday. And so just to get a glimpse at what they thought about it, gather around these screens here so you can see. We're going to show you a really short video of their reaction to this.
Speed sent an email.
What time did he send it?
9:20. because I got it this morning.
Good.